Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have for you guys the Bad Habit Light Speed eyeshadow palette that is meant to be the Kat Von D Divine palette dupe. So if you guys want to see how I use this palette, please make sure you keep on watching. Alright, so before we get into how I created this look using this palette, a few details. I got this palette, of course, off of Shop Hush. So if you're familiar with makeup, you know about Hush. They often have good dupes on there for popular palettes, and they're much more affordable. So last week they released, well, by the time I post this, it'll be 2 weeks ago, they released this, the Bad Habit Light Speed palette, which was meant to dupe the Kat Von D Divine palette. I forgot what it was called. I was originally interested in that palette, but then I swatched some of the colors at Sephora, and for $38, I just felt like it didn't perform well for me on my skin tone. So of course, when I saw that Shop Hush had created their own version of it, I was super excited, just because, like, even if this doesn't work, I think I paid $12 for it, so, you know, that's not too bad. So I've already created this look, so I have my own feelings about it. I've also used this palette yesterday when I got it, so I've had enough time to kind of experiment with the colors. I can tell you all right now, this glittery shade in here which is right here, it's called Orbit. It would definitely need to be used with a glitter primer. It was just glitter everywhere when I tried to use it. So it's more like a glitter than a shadow, which if you're into that, then cool, no problems. But I was expecting it to be more like a metallic shade. And it just wasn't that. So if you can imagine, yesterday I had glitter like all over my face. Good thing I did not do my foundation and stuff before using it yesterday, because I would have been pissed. So other than that, now I know, like, if I want to use that shadow, I probably need to use something that's going to stick the glitter to the eye. I'll go ahead and swatch the shades for you because you probably want to see that. So here's the white, which for white, it's not terrible, but I can't use that. The black. That's a pretty decent black for the price of this palette. We know that whites and blacks are often hard to make because they can become really patchy. And that white just looks like chalk, so that's going to be something I don't use. This blue, which I was really excited about, but I mean, it's all right. It's all right. It's work withable. I'm often wary of colors like that because of my skin tone, but it's okay. Here's another blue. It's called Momentum. The other blue was called Hyperdrive. This was Black Hole, and that was Blast Off. So now we're at Momentum, which is that that royal blue, and it's a metallic shade, and it's pretty, pretty. I really like that color. I feel like blue is going to be my summer color. Here's the green that I have on my eye, which I place right here. Also a very pretty color. It's called Supersonic Orbit, which is that glittery shade I was talking about. Like, look at it. It's gorgeous, but definitely, definitely, definitely use some type of glitter glue, because, like, look at my finger. It's super glittery. But it's a gorgeous color, I'm not gonna lie. And yeah, now the glitter is like all over my desk. Here's Gravity, which is like a gray charcoal. And then Force, which is, I don't know, I have it on my eye, I can't really describe it. It's like a more of a yellowish, greenish color. Can't really tell. So here are the swatches. It's a very pretty palette. So what do I think about this palette? I think that for $10, this palette is amazing. I think for a dupe, this palette is amazing. But if we take away the price and the fact that it's a dupe, there are only two shadows that I think perform consistently well, and that's Black Hole, the black color, and Supersonic, the green color. The other colors are kind of patchy, that being the white and that light blue shadow, that's Hyperdrive. And also, no, I take that back. Charcoal, That charcoal color, Gravity, is also one that performs well. So that's three colors out of the palette that performs to my standard. The white, the blue, and that silver is like, yeah, it's work withable, but I've noticed with that matte blue shade, I really have to keep working it in, keep working it in, keep working it in for it to show on my eyelid. I used that color yesterday, but that took a really long time just because on the eye, it didn't show up as pigmented as it does here on a swatch. So, you know, there's that. Would I buy it again? Yes. The formulas of the shadows are not bad at all, and I feel like for the price, it's something good to have in the collection just because that color scheme is so pretty. I do want to mention that I don't have a highlight color in here as well as any transition colors. So I had to dip into my Perception palette, which I do love, and I have a video on it. All right, so let's get into how I use that palette to create this look. Thank you guys so much for watching this video today. If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos from me, make sure you subscribe to my channel. And as always, I will see you next video. You said you're down for me, care for me, care for me.